What's going on, fellas? We're back at it again with another video. First off, I just want to thank everyone for the support. We've been crushing it lately. All the car videos have been performing super well, and I won't be able to do it without you guys. So shout out everyone that's been watching the videos. Today, we're going to take a look at imported cars. Now, a lot of the most hyped up cars are turning 25 years old or already have recently turned 25 years old. So the demand for wanting to import a car from Japan is pretty high right now. And a ton of people are going to splurge out and buy their dream car that they can finally own after waiting for so long. But with any business that has money involved in it, there's always going to be scammers and some pretty shady characters involved in it. If you guys know Doug DeMuro, you probably know about Cars and Bids, which is an auction website where you could buy and sell cars. Well, a couple weeks ago, a GTR R34 was posted onto Cars and Bids, and at first glance, it seems like nothing's wrong with it. Unless you do a really deep dive that certain things about this car are just super suspicious. First off, the VIN tag is fake and has Japanese writing with many mistakes in it. The font is super off and it has some really thick characters. If you compare it to an actual authentic Japanese VIN tag, the characters look super different side to side. So we know that this car has a fake VIN tag. The fake VIN tag looks like they got it off Temu. This car was also listed a while back and it had 20,000 more miles than it currently does have. So this means that they did something weird with the mileage of the car. The final nail in the coffin was that this car was last registered in Japan in 2003. So this V-Spec Skyline is just super shady. And the crazy thing about this is that this car went for over $100,000. If you're buying a car for $100,000, you expect all the paperwork to be in order and for everything to be near perfect on this car. This car was also inspected by Cars and Bids, which means nothing like this should even be happening. So Cars and Bids definitely messed this one up. The next one we have is a shady importer that got exposed a couple times. His name is Mark Asega. I think that's how I pronounce it. Asega. AKA his business is called Bonsai Imports. And a lot of people are alleging that they got sold damaged and even in some cases the complete wrong car. Now this person is alleging that he was supposed to get a turbo R34 but instead he got a GTV. So Bonsai Imports pretty much bait and switched this guy. But upon even further investigation, one of the admins of the Facebook group actually ran the VIN through a VIN decoder and they found out that this car is actually a 25 GT. So this person pretty much got sold the complete wrong car. The same importer also sold someone a Laurel with a rolled back odometer. The importer also posted a fake review onto Facebook. A fake make-believe customer posted that they got a car from them and that they love it. When in reality, we got the whole entire sheet of the car and the car wasn't even running at some point and they had to use a forklift on the car. And this car had everything replaced on it because it was falling apart and it was just horrible. And that the post was made just to resell the R32. So honestly, bro, if you're going to buy a car, buy it from someone with multiple trusted reviews. Make sure knowledgeable people have vouched for this person, you feel me? Because if you buy it off some random, the possibilities of getting scammed are super high. And most people will do anything for a little bit of money. So anyway, fellas, if you guys want more videos like this, drop a like, drop a sub, and let's get it. If you guys want longer videos, tell me right now. Let's go.